What is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Berm, and today I am hitting the VGC Series 8 ranked ladder with this Ho-Oh team that was passed to me by a subscriber by the name of Liminator. Go check out Liminator. Liminator's channel link will be in the description below. Excellent team builder, has made a team for me before, has made teams. Yeah, I've seen his teams around. Liminator. Household name, Liminator. Go check him out. I'm really excited to use Ho-Oh because we used Lugia, and I think there was some interest in seeing Ho-Oh in action as well. I know James Beck has used Ho-Oh to some success, and I'm excited to use it for myself here. Seems pretty straightforward. Regenerator is Ho-Oh's signature, not a signature ability, because other people get it, but it's a good ability that Ho-Oh gets. And just a lot of support around him, Milotic to just to counter opposing Incineroars and our own Incineroar, because Incineroar's great. And Cartana just has really good chemistry with Ho-Oh. They have some great type synergy there. But you'll see that in these battles. I've never used this team. I'm excited to try it out for the first time on camera, on YouTube, in front of millions of people. I wish. But hey, if you want to help this reach millions of people, like, comment, and subscribe. If you are new, come join the Discord for free. Link to that is in the description below. Check out some of my other Series 8 teams in the description below. Make sure you hit the notification bell because I got more teams coming this week. I myself made a Rayquaza team that's going to come out in a day or two after this video comes out. So definitely be on the lookout for that. If you're interested in getting a membership to the channel, those are now live. You can find out more by hitting the join button on this page. You won't immediately join, okay? It will show you what the memberships are. And I think you might be surprised because the lowest one's pretty cheap and you get some pretty cool stuff. So I would check that out. But definitely join the Discord for free because that's fun too. I stream Thursday nights at 8. And let's jump into these first battles, shall we? Whoa, Swampert on the field. That's so fun. I even before I saw the Swampert, I liked my Cartana. Cartana has a really good time in this game. Let's be frank. I honestly don't know, like, what does my team do against opposing Regieleki's? Cartana, I guess, right? Like, I guess I could lead Clefairy Cartana off the jump. I guess that's fine. And then Ho-Oh in the back. Once I clean up that Regieleki, Ho-Oh has a pretty good matchup. Milotic because of theirs. Like, I don't think I bring my Regieleki to this game. My Regieleki doesn't really do anything. I can bring my Incin. Milotic's more fun, though. They have a grass type. I'm bringing Milotic. If you say Milotic, I apologize. Milotic isn't... What is with the bad trainer card? Do anything to it. Anything different. Regieleki and Serena, the rank master. What do you know? Clefairy and Cortana, the rank master. I got the shiny boys. I could probably just helping hands here. Well, what if the Serena has a fighting move? I guess I should follow me. I could get big and just go for a max. I could Airstream into the Serena. Or I could try to... I want to try to get rid of that Leki. I think the Leki is the scariest thing for this team. But these are the two Pokemon I want to get rid of. So I got no problem pulling out Cartana here. Making him big and just trying to delete him for the rest of my friends. They've presented me with the two Pokemon who, like, literally threaten the rest of my team. Wretched Lucky goes for Reflect. Smart. This is still going to do a ton of damage, though, because they are, I don't know if you know this, a Wretched Lucky. Is that a crit? It wasn't. That's just a good time. It's not a crit. That's just a good time. And they taunted my Clefairy. It's a little too late, in my opinion. They could come into... who? Oh, Zacian wants to come out now. Again. That's fine. I wish I had literally Incineroar for this exact moment. But I could double into the Zacian, actually. Well, I don't think Zacian threatens my Cortana. I could go Ho-Oh here from Clefairy pretty easily. And especially if I get an Airstream boost, that's really great against the Zacian. So we're going to Airstream into Serena on this turn. They could go for a Steel Move into Clefairy right now with Zacian. Some say Zacian. In case you had no idea who I was talking about just now. Talking about Zacian. They did attack my Cortana. That does so much damage even though it's not very effective. Shout out Zacian. You're strong. Shout out Zacian. You strong. You strong, dude. That was a plus one into a Koba Berry. For those taking note. Oh, it was actually a crit, so I don't think the Koba Berry even came into play there. That's a Power Whip into my Fire Flying type. So, you know, I don't mind. And what we can do so easily now is we can just Airstream into that Serena and Sacred Fire into the Zacian. I said Zacian now. No, I'm saying it, man. Even though it's wrong. There's not a ton my opponent can do about this. I mean, you could go out of Serena and go into Incineroar to get a drop on my Ho-Oh, but like even then I don't know what that does to us. Like a Sacred Fire is still gonna like really crush Zacian, so we just gotta hit the Sacred Fire because Sacred Fire is not guaranteed to hit, right? Yeah, pretty sure it's not fully accurate, but it's got a really good burn chance. Does it have, what do I know about this move? It is not as accurate, but it has a better burn chance. Is that the idea? No burn there. A wild charge, though. Holy cow. I mean, they're going to knock themselves out. Because I have so much HP. Wow, they didn't even knock themselves out, though. I'm impressed. I am truly impressed. I'm also sitting at plus two speed still. And I still have a Clefairy that could really hook me up. Urshifu. They did not bring their Incin. They did not bring somebody who could fake out. So all I gotta do is I gotta follow me. And I gotta clip this Zacian. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Pretty sure this will do it. I'll outspeed everything. Finish off the Zacian, get my third attack boost. We really scared them out of bringing the the Milotic really scared them out of bringing the Incineroar. Not bad. Wicked Blow really does nothing to Clefairy. And what's so funny is if they're Focus Sesh, Clefairy might be getting this. Oh, no, they're not. Never mind. Never mind. It's going to be Cortana. If they were Sash, Clefairy would have gotten this last kill. Because I'm going for Moonblood. Better believe I'm going for Moonblood. Yeah, it's Sacred Sword. Yeah, the team worked really well there. I liked that. Felt really good. I mean, Ho-Oh is such a really, like, if they are running a Zacian team, Ho-Oh is a great answer to it. And I was just really glad that we were able to get rid of the Regieleki before Ho-Oh came out, right? Because if you can do that, like, what Urshifu, Zacian, and Serena had no shot against Ho-Oh unless you were going for your wild charge into my Ho-Oh, in which case you're deleting half your HP. So, good game to my opponent. My opponent's name is R. Rocket? Maybe. They have some super effective Pokemon against me. Well, actually, Ice is not super effective. It's just regular effective. But they have potential Rock Slide, which isn't fun, but I'm faster, but also Intimidate. Yeah, I mean, they have a lot of Intimidate, and I have Milotic. So Milotic comes to this game. Milotic, actually, Regieleki, Milotic, Clefairy, and Ho-Oh, maybe. Could do some pretty good work. What I do like about Ho-Oh's matchup here is the Amoongus. I don't like Milotic or Regieleki against Amoongus, but Ho-Oh has safety goggles and is, like, super effective in every way. Come on, man. Decorate your card even a little bit. Even just a little would be great. Okay, Zapdos, Amoongus, right there. They did not lead with either of their attackers. They're, you know, big boy attackers. I could just protect and switch into... Well, I don't want to switch into Ho-Oh if there's an electric type on the field, you know? So maybe I just T-Bolt the Zapdos. What is Milotic's item? Sorry. It is the Adrenaline Orb, which I love. I could go Ho-Oh here. I'm going to go Ho-Oh here. If they go for an electric move, you know what? We have... I mean, they're probably going to go for an electric move. We have Regenerator for a reason, correct? Correct. And I have Protect, you know. I have ways around that. They are just going to go for Spore, I think, into something. And I really hope it's into the... into that Ho-Oh slot, but it could so easily just be into Regieleki. Yeah. I hate Spore so much. Ugh. It didn't not cross my mind to go for... like, Dynamax set Electric Terrain. But I'm not that real, unfortunately. Just not that real. That's a pretty easy turn to just protect a bunch on. Not sure what else my opponent could do there. So now let's just T-Bolt the Zapdos again, I think. And I can switch Ho-Oh back out, this time into Clefairy. Clefairy will take a Thunderbolt, I think. Should. Definitely should. Ooh, all these shinies are nice. Very nice. We are going to take turn two sleep. Unfortunate. Clefairy takes that, but doesn't love that. And they are going to Spore Clefairy now, too, so... Ho-Oh would have eaten that Spore, but not the Thunderbolt, unfortunately. But we can now Helping... Well, Helping Hand's not going to do anything, right? So, there's really no point in revealing that we have... I mean, let's assume that I have Helping Hand, right? But, you know what I mean? If you know what I mean, you know what I mean. I'll say no more. Three turns of sleep. Sick. Heat Wave's gonna come out. Sick. Maybe I can get lucky here and get the Helping Hand. Oh, no. Clear Smog. I'm actually gonna live that. Okay. Maybe I can get lucky here. Thunderbolt, Helping Hand, and we can get both wake-ups right here. That would be so clutch. We're going to get the Regieleki wake-up. We know that. We've had three turns of sleep. Can't be any more turns. But if Clefairy could wake up, we could kill this Zapdos here. I am sad. I am quite sad. Come on, Thunderbolt. And there's a nice sick heat wave. Okay. I gotta go I gotta make something happen here, man. I mean, they could so easily just, like... I might Dynamax Regieleki here, dude. If I Dynamax Leki, I'm doing it. I'm Dynamaxing Leki. I'm trying to kill this Zapdos. Maybe they safety goggles. But that's why I should also Sacred Fire into the Zapdos, because if I do that, and they... Like, I'm either going to kill the Zapdos and then Sacred Fire into the Amoongus, or they're going to Rage Powder. I'll go for the Max Lightning into the Amoongus, but I'll still Sacred Fire the Zapdos because I have Safety Goggles on. Safety Goggles blocks all Powder moves, including Rage Powder. If I'm wrong about that, we're going to find out in a second, but I'm pretty sure I'm right about that. It's not going to be who you think here, pal. I'll tell you that much. This is not about to be who you think. Was this wrong? Did I do this bad? I got to stop the spores, man. I got to stop them. They did Rage Powder, so the electric terrain will be set up. Freaking Sacred Fire to kill this Zapdos. I don't know if that's possible. Maybe I'm crazy for thinking it isn't, and maybe I'm crazy for thinking it is. But T-Bolt is definitely landing into Ho-Oh. Ho-Oh's definitely not liking it, but is also definitely not dead. Here we go. I like it. I like that a lot. Now, if you have Landorus, there's no better time for Landorus, unfortunately. And how do you not bring Landorus this game, right? Like, it's pretty obvious that you should. I'm going to max guard Leki, and I'm going to go for the recover. Are they going to earthquake here, or are they going to rock slide here? You know what? I might just say goodbye to Ho-Oh. I could switch out. Let's switch out into Milotic, actually. I'm going to get some regenerator. I'm going to use this regenerator. I have regenerator. Why not use it? If they go for Earthquake, Milotic's not going to hate it. And also, they can't put me to sleep now because Electric Terrain. It might just be a Rock Slide, though. Nope, they're going to Protect. Okay, this is probably an Earthquake. No. They Rock Slid. Clean. I could still go for a really big max lightning into this. Like, I can't hit the Landorus, unfortunately. But I have Muddy Water, and I have Ice Beam. So I'm going to Ice Beam into this Lando. Hopefully I kill the Amoongus with the electric move now that the electric train's up. It's not impossible. And then Lando will not like this Ice Beam. And if they have the Incense in the back, do I know who they have in the back? Zacian comes out right now. Why? This has got to be Rock Slide. Maybe they're locked into Rock Slide? Why would you sack your Zacian here? Hello? That's your wolf. Maybe they just really didn't think I would ever go for an electric move into the Amoongus there. Weird. We got a weird alert. That was strange. Why'd they do that? And then I don't even know what Fly is going to do here. Like, I'm definitely T-bolting. Like, they have to go for Rage Powder here or they die. Right? And if they go for Rage Powder, then I'm just going to kill their Amoongus here. Suddenly, this game looks pretty winnable. Pretty good for me. And I stand by my decision to Dynamax the Regieleki, ultimately. Fly comes out in two. They should be attacking Milotic. Ooh, that almost killed Milotic. That is tight. That was a tight one. Damn, I mean, they did the right thing, right? They could just go for Rock Slides now. Or they could go for Earthquakes. And Regieleki has no business being here. So, like, I could try to go for Ho-Oh. I could try to protect here. But maybe Milotic is who needs to switch into Ho-Oh. Like, maybe I need to protect here and go into Ho-Oh here. Oh, God. They could still just win by Rock Sliding throughout. They did enough damage to Milotic that Milotic's just in trouble now. And I can't slow down the Landorus since it's a ground type. Rock Slide's just going to eliminate Ho-Oh, but they can also miss Rock Slide, so hopefully they do something dumb here. Yay! They did dumb. They did dumb. And now I can go Milotic just in case they miss a Rock Slide. I could go Recover. If I'm faster than the Landorus, I need to be faster than the Landorus anyway, but if I'm faster than the Landorus, then I would also... I guess there's no real reason to. If I Recover, it would make me not flying type anymore. Oh no, it's not Roost. It is Recover. That would not work. That's actually a thing that would not work. I could Sacred Fire into Lando, try to get the burn. God, is that dumb, though? I guess Brave Bear would have been smarter there, huh? Oh, boy. I don't know. This is still pretty yikes-ish. Yeah, and they didn't even Dynamax yet. I mean, yeah, man, a Rock Fall into Ho-Oh right here, I think, seals it. I just can't touch him with the Regieleki is the thing. So, Landorus being their last Pokemon, and Regieleki being my Pokemon that lived this whole game, is just like, that is ultimately what is very bad. And they outsped me anyway. Okay. Well, yeah, Lando just cleans up this whole game, unfortunately. As weird as it is to like look at one Pokemon versus my three Pokemon and be like, they win. They win this. That is exactly what happens here. Like, you look at my Ho-Oh, my Milotic, and my Regieleki against a full HP Landorus that is faster than Milotic and Ho-Oh. Landorus just wins that. And it's so weird to say that, but like, I mean, by all means, and I don't need to say this, I know that people will. Tell me in the comments below how I could have played this better. You know, what turn I could have done anything different. That'd be great. They attacked Leki there, dude. I could crit kill. You have to attack Milotic there. Even if I'm going to die to sand right here, I could crit kill right now. I don't know if a crit kill would have... Oh my god, if sand wasn't happening. Oh no, they had Lum. That's the weirdest. I mean, you didn't think that was still left in this battle, did you? Yeah, tell me how I could have played that different, because truly, I don't even know. I don't even know. I mean, I guess I could have brought a different Pokemon, right? But like, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. No use crying over spilled milk. Good game to my opponent. Oh man, I like Edgar's team a lot. What a cool, fun, whatever this is. Something I will say about my team is I don't love my answers for Regieleki, and I don't love my I don't have terrain control, which is fine. You know, you don't need these things, but it's something that I usually build into my teams, so it's just how I'm comfortable playing. You maybe don't do that, and so this team maybe is a little like, maybe you know exactly what to do here. But I mean, Kartana worked out for us pretty well last time. We can reset the terrain with Kartana too. And yes, I'm going to the God, I don't want to be in a situation where I get stuck against Landers again with my Lucky. So why don't we lead Clefairy, and we'll bring Ho-Oh, and we'll bring Milotic, or my own Incin. I like Milotic. You know what I'm looking at? Just like what's gonna happen here is that they are going to lead their top two Pokemon. I have a shot at living that, because if I Dynamax Kartana turn one, then they're going for not very effective moves into an Assault Vest. But Kartana, like, the reason you put Assault Vest on Kartana is to make its special defense stat normal. It's not to make its special defense stat good, because it has nothing to start. It's literally paper thin, and you know the developers did that on purpose. So they end up with their Kartana. They got the psychic terrain going. I don't think it's worth my time to go for a follow me. I think if they're going to go for two moves, they're going to go for spread moves. So I think I can get big. I think I can go for an Airstream into the Indeedee. No, I think I want to get rid of the terrain. Let's do that. And I can go for that. And I can go for Helping Hand, I think. Or Moonblast. Actually, you know what? Moonblast is really great to break sashes. So we're going to Moonblast. I'm not concerned. Like, I think that when it comes to OKOing either of these Pokemon, assuming they don't Dynamax, I think Kartana's got it. But if they follow me here, then, and they have a sash, then I will pop that sash. I'm popping sashes. Okay. I'm not just going to sit here and let myself get double targeted while I go for a follow me. They Volt Switch out. This is probably going to go into Incin, which is, that's worst case scenario, because they could so easily, like, they didn't follow me. So what if they went for a Mystical Fire? The Lando comes out. I don't hate this. I like going for, even if it's a minus one, I like going for a neutral move into this Incin, or into this Landorus. I don't mind that at all. And actually, I'm resetting the terrain, so they can't even really go for expanding, like, limiting their access to expanding force. That's not too bad either. I don't mind that. Clefairy is also going to help Kartana live whatever this is about to be. It's expanding force, and it's into Kartana. That did nothing. Okay, good. And we get the little Moonblast out into the Landers. That was not a little Moonblast. That was a big boy Moonblast that I'm actually pretty proud of. So I think I can now go for, I think I should go for Overgrowth into Indeedee. And I'm going to go for another Moonblast into Landorus. Because if I kill this Indeedee, like if this Indeedee is not Focus Sashed, which now I'm thinking it is. Regardless, I'm going to either kill the Indeedee now on this turn, or I'm going to attack this Landorus and kill it with my Clefairy. Because I don't know what Landorus is going to do here that's going to stop Clefairy. Besides, like, they could Dynamax and target Clefairy. And that might kill Clefairy. Landorus is back out. They're coming back into Incin. Mewtwo's coming out now. Okay. I can't eat my Aviolite now. And Didi goes for follow me. And I don't even care, dude. Barring the Reggie Le- Oh, that's not true. No, because Mewtwo will also now... But I still have access to Follow Me, man. Clefairy's coming in clutch with these Moonblasts right now. Oh, yeah. Yes. Yes, sir. We lose another attack drop. Okay. But what I can do is I can... They're going to Dynamax that Mewtwo, right? I think that's pretty much a given. But I can now air... Yeah, I can do that and I can Follow Me. Even though I'm at minus two, I can get back up to minus one if I kill this Landorus. And an Airstream might make me faster than Lecky. Is that crazy to say? Maybe that's so crazy to say. But if it does, then on the next turn, even at minus one, in Grassy Train, I think Kartana has a pretty good shot at one-shotting a Regieleki. Call me crazy. I think that can happen. And then it's just about stalling out the Mewtwo, because the Mewtwo is going to Dynamax here. I mean, I'd bet my house on it. I don't own a house. I don't own a house. So I can bet my house on it pretty easily. They're going to switch out the Landorus. Wow, they're really holding out hope, huh? Lecky will live a minus two Airstream. It will. But I'm still hoping that we're able to get faster than it. Pretty confident that we will be. How confident am I? You say that, and then it's a Regieleki, and you're like, how was I so naive? So it's hard to say. Hey, Mewtwo. Thanks for guarding. That was great. You're just giving me, like, health to play with. That's a very little damage, but I'm still unafraid. Like, I'm going to keep in Kartana. Actually, I could Helping Hand here. I don't think I even care if... Because I think I'm now going to definitely outspeed the Mewtwo. But I don't think I die to the Lecky. Even if the Lecky goes for like a Volt Switch or something. I think I Leaf Blade into the Regieleki. And I think I Helping Hand right now. Maybe they protect Regieleki. And that would be a really like amazing move on my opponent's part. But... I think I can pull this out. Oh man, but they're going to lower my speed. Oh no. Which is going to make me slower than Mewtwo. Mewtwo could have a fire move. Mindstorm. I know that wasn't a mistake. I know they didn't just forget that it was not very effective because it shows you. It tells you on the thing. Oh, but that raised their Spidef. That's kind of fun. And we still didn't kill Lecky. Wow. I'm actually pretty surprised by that. But I can still kill Lecky. And I can still waste turns of this Dynamax if I now Follow Me. Clefairy is going to go down here if they attack with both of their Pokemon. But even if they switch out the Lecky, I'm going to kill that Landorus. I don't care if I'm at minus two. I don't care if that would make me at minus three. All right? What's a little concerning is the potential expanding forces that are going to be coming out of this Mewtwo once it's not Dynamax. But if I can kill all its friends before that, that could be good. Lando comes back out. Getting that last Intimidate. It's really not going to matter. I really do think that I'll kill this thing. Even if I am at minus three. Max Knuckle! It was attacking my Kartana. It was attacking the Kartana there. And it let me stay alive even more. Oh my gosh. Dude, you're just in trouble. You have to get rid of one of these two Pokemon. And you're targeting the wrong one. I'm back up to minus two, baby. Yeah, they go Reggie Leck. I'll tell you something. Electro Web. I'm concerned about Expanding Force. Electro Web plus Expanding Force could kill Kartana, which is why. Woof. Okay. Yeah, this could be pretty. Oh, this could be really, really scary here. I got to kill that Regieleki. If they go for Expanding Force and Electro Web, they could kill both of my Pokemon. Oh my god, wait. Am I going to lose this battle? Whoa. Whoa. Okay. Okay. I have to double the Regieleki. I have to kill Regieleki before anybody else comes in. And I think I have to Moonblast in the Regieleki too, because I don't think there's any way they don't go for two spread moves here. Into Clefairy? Wow. I mean, I didn't see that coming. Am I going to live this Expanding Force? Nah, the Assault Fest wasn't enough. Like I said, that was just a regular special defense stat there. At that point. Okay. We have to still kill the Leki. I have to protect my Milotic, I think. It's gonna be tight. It's gonna be tight. If they double into either of my Pokemon, it's pretty bad. I have to like pretty much call the Pokemon they're gonna go for here. I just don't know who they're going to go for. They could also just not go for anybody, and they could just... I think I have to just protect somebody. I think Ho has the best chance of living. Like, I've still got to operate under the assumption that it's going to be Electro Web and Expanding Forces here. No! And they're just hitting Thunders cold, man. That's wild. That's wild. They're just hitting Thunders. I can't believe Thunder is the move they have on this team. It's not even a rain team, is it? I mean, they could be stuck in Thunder right now, you know? So maybe there's still a shot if they miss a Thunder. I can't believe I'm going to lose this battle, though. They missed the Thunder! That does so much damage. I need to get a accuracy drop on the Mewtwo. Please? Ooh, but Psychic Drain does go away. What are you going to do? It doesn't matter. They're going to win. But I just can't believe that if I'd protected Ho-Oh instead... How do you not Electro Web on that turn? I guess they're scared of getting the stat drop on Milotic, but that's so foreign to me. I can't believe you don't like. How do you? I'd have won just if I'd protected the right Pokemon. I guess I should have assumed they were gonna go for Ho-Oh. Because Ho-Oh's the legendary, right? I don't know. I think I just made a bad call there, but I'm also confused about why they were single targeting and not double targeting when we know they could have. They could have so easily just gone for Electro Web and Expanding Force and covered both of their bases. And it's the fact that they single targeted that hurts so much. Good game to my opponent. Hey, thanks so much for checking out this video. If you enjoyed this team, be sure to like and comment to let me know, help the video reach more people, and help other people find Liminator's rental code for this fun Ho-Oh team. Thanks again to Liminator for this team. I feel like I wasn't able to make it work today, and I think it may have been my fault. I didn't manage to get up a Dynamax Ho-Oh like I kind of wanted to. But maybe you can. You know, it's still a Ho-Oh team that you can use, and that's kind of the idea here, using the team so that other people can get the rental code, even if I wasn't able to use it today. I was able to use Kartana in a way that makes me feel good, because the Kartana Ho-Oh combination is really powerful. There's actually Kartana on the Rayquaza team that I'm going to be using in my next video. So if you like Kartana, there's more Kartana to come. All right. But other than that, I feel like we got some good battles, even if, you know, we lost over 50% of them. It's going to happen. It's going to happen in some of these videos. But regardless, thank you so much for watching. Again, I stream on Thursday nights at 8. I have a free Discord that is linked in the description below. I also have memberships if you're interested. Learn more by clicking the join button. And until next time, my name is Berm. See you later. Yay! They did dumb.